Hello everyone, myself Dr. Milind Kumar Suresoni, working as assistant professor in RCP Institute of Technology, Sherpur. Today I am going to deliver video presentation on sustainability of wind power plant. Before discuss on today's presentation, just overlook on last week video presentation. In first week, I have prepared video presentation on introduction on wind power plant and their working condition. And second week, I have prepared video presentation on industrial norms for wind power plant. The details of this particular video is discussed in this slide. The outcome of both previous video are wind energy resources is green, sustainable and affordable source of energy. The working condition of wind power plant is explained in these videos and also discuss on sustainability of the wind power plant. The plan for wind power plant installation to fulfill the present and future energy needs. Industry standard or norms applicable for installation of wind power plant. In today's video presentation, I have discussed on list of ISO standard for wind power plant. Here there's a numbers of ISO standard is applicable for wind power plant, but in this presentation I have discussed only few of them. The first one is ISO 16079. The purpose of this ISO standard is to monitoring and diagnostic of wind turbines. It gives the general guidelines. This applicable for failure mode detection, diagnostics and probe diagnostics of wind power plant components. Another one is ISO 81400. The purpose of this ISO is to design wind turbine gearbox, wind turbine and gearbox. This ISO is applicable for all types of gearbox and it helps to design such a gearbox which is having longer life. The next one is ISO 29400. The purpose of this ISO is ship and marine technology offshore wind energy plant and its operation. It is applicable to develop and provide comprehensive requirement and guideline for planning, engineering and safe execution of port and marine operation for all types of components of offshore wind farm, including cable laying and dividing support vessel, but excluding floating structures. The references of all ISOs is represented in these slides. The next one important topic, how many carbon emission is due to the working windmill power plant. This graph represent the CO2 emission per kilowatt during electricity production by different plants, and it is found that the wind power plant's carbon footprint is among the smallest of any other energy sources. The wind power plant and nuclear power plant produce near about 11 gram of CO2 per kilowatt of electricity generation. The reference of this graph is represented in this slide. The sustainability of wind power plant is this plant is having longer life, near about 20 years, but it required regular maintenance for routine operations. The output of wind power plant depends on the turbine size and wind speed through the rotor. Here the example is provided for the energy produced by 1.5 megawatt turbine, which having the 25% capacity factor. That means a 1.5 megawatt multiply 365 days multiply by 24 hours and multiply by capacity factor 25%. We get the there is a 3285 megawatt hours in a year. The calculation of power which is generated by solar wind power plant is calculated by using the formula 1/2 rho a v cube. Rho is the effect of air density, a is the effect of swept area, and v is the effect of wind speed. Wind swept area is found with the help of pi r square, and it is measured in a meter square. The figure represents the all parameters. The concluding remark of today's presentation is the wind power plant contribute to sustainable development. It reduces CO2 emission, that is greenhouse gases emission is reduces. Creation of local employment, reduce pollution from fossil fuel power generation, helping to stimulate the growth of renewable energy development. Thank you.